Christians have been called to be in the world but not of the world. But with the sin, temptation and evil, how are we supposed to be different? Stay tuned as we find out. So Christians are called to be different and not better. In Matthew 5:14 it reads, "You are the light of the world. A city set on a hill cannot be hidden. Let your light shine before men in such a way that they may see your good works and glorify your Father who is in heaven." So the light, this means standing out, seeing your good works, being different. Romans 12 verse 2 also reads, "And do not be conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind, so that you may prove what the will of God is, that which is good and acceptable and perfect." Keyword conformed. This is being molded into being like the world. Keyword being transformed. The Holy Spirit's transformation in us makes us think and act differently to the world. So how can we be different today when the world's mostly against our views? Christians are supposed to hate sin, yet the world celebrates it. Being honest, it's not an easy walk. It's easy to be pulled into things which you know you shouldn't do, and it's easy to follow the crowd and walk the easy path, yet we are not called to do this. We're going to look at six general worldly views or topics and then compare this to the Christian view. Again, it's just a generalization. I don't mean everyone, but this is some worldly views. So before I start, I want to make it clear that everyone was once in the world. A Christian was once a part of the world, living like the world, looking like the world, yet they've been set apart because of what Jesus has done for them, not because how good they are. So I'm no better than you watching this video now. I'm just different. So let's jump into it. Number one, the world says, "Do whatever your heart desires." The Bible says, Jeremiah 17:9, "The heart is more deceitful than all else and is desperately sick. Who can understand it?" It's sick because we are born with a sinful nature, meaning it's natural for us in this condition to sin. We need the Holy Spirit's power to help us overcome the fleshly desires. Number two, the world says, "Looking is okay as long as you don't touch." The Bible says, Matthew 5:27-28 reads, "You have heard that it was said, you shall not commit adultery. But I say to you that everyone who looks at a woman with lust for her has already committed adultery with her in his heart." We all have sexual desires, which is normal. However, filling your mind continually with those thoughts is damaging and wrong. If the act is wrong, so is the intention. But let's be real here. It's happened to us all where we've been standing there and we cannot control who or what walks past us or what's on the billboard as we drive past it. But what we can control is, do we leave them thoughts in our mind? Do we continually think about them? Or do we try and remove them straight away? We need to be faithful to our wife or to your husband, not just physically, but with the eyes also. And also, I've seen something which was pretty frightening on the TV the other day, advertising called Temptation Island. And it was a couple of men sat around the pool, and obviously a wonderfully looking woman walked past, and I thought to myself, this is exactly how the world lives. In the Bible, it teaches temptation, how to overcome it, but this is just flaunting it as if it's a joke. And temptations in the flesh are not a joke, they're real, and it affects everyone. So I thought that was pretty shocking. And whilst we're on this subject, pornography, a lot of people will say that is normal or that is okay to watch, but according to God, this is definitely not. Again, this is the lust of the eyes and the flesh. We need the Holy Spirit's power to help us overcome the lust. Number three, the The world says there's no need to get married. It's just an expensive day for a ring and a piece of paper. The Bible says in Mark 10, 6 through 9, it reads, "But from the beginning of creation, God made them male and female. For this reason, a man shall leave his father and mother, and the two shall become one flesh. So they are no longer two, but one flesh. What therefore God has joined together, let no man separate." That is referencing Genesis 2, so the beginning of creation. So since the beginning of creation, this has been God's intention for people. Obviously, not everyone gets married. I understand that. It is no longer you living, but you and your spouse are one. It's about oneness. It's about wholeness. There's no yours, mine, it's ours. It's a total lifelong commitment. We need the Holy Spirit's power to either A, keep our marriage healthy, or B, keep us patient and wait for the right person to be put into our lives. Number four, the world says chase money and fame. The Bible says in Hebrews 13:5, make sure that your character is free from the love of money, being content with what you have. So there's nothing wrong with being famous or rich, but what's your motive for wanting it? If it produces pride, greed, boastfulness, arrogance, then it's wrong. It's sad because so many kids these days, they seem to be chasing it because of what they see on their phones. And it is such a sad state that we're in. We need to get away from this. A massive word was content, which is a beautiful word. We need the Holy Spirit's power to help us to be more content with what we have instead of what we don't have. If you're watching this and you live in England, it's like we've already won the lottery. Look around the world. We are so blessed, it's ridiculous. Point number five. The world says, don't forgive the person, make them pay. Sorry, I'm being a bit dramatic. The Bible says in Ephesians 4, 31 through 32, let all bitterness and wrath and anger and clamour and slander be put away from you, along with all malice. Be kind to one another, tender-hearted, forgiving each other, just as God in Christ also has forgiven you. First off, I and a lot of Christians will have empathy for people who have had or are going through terrible situations, and I cannot understand what you're feeling or what you're feeling against that other person. So I'm not here to tell you how. I'm just reading the scripture, and hopefully this will help you. So let's carry on. The world will tell you to drag the person down to the gutters, maybe tell you to feel happy if that person's life goes downhill. However, a Christian should be the most forgiving person in the whole world. Just remember what Jesus did on the cross for your sins. Let that sink in. We need the Holy Spirit's power to help us forgive people and also to bring the remembrance about how we've been forgiven. Number six. The world says everyone's allowed their opinion. It's a free world. And I've not got a scripture, but the reason I've said this is because people say this and believe this until somebody says something that they don't agree with. As Christians, we hold that the Bible is the ultimate standard of living. However, we know that this view is the minority. If we voiced the biblical opinions, which they're not opinions, they're just facts, in certain places, then this could get us into a lot of trouble. Yet, supposedly, everybody is entitled to their opinion, which is quite ironic. We need the Holy Spirit's power to help us be brave in these situations and stand up for the truth, but importantly, speaking this in love. So, who are you following watching this video now? The world? Let's read us another scripture about this. 1 John 2, 15, 16 reads, do not love the world nor the things in the world. If anyone loves the world, the love of the Father is not in him. For all that is in the world, the lust of the flesh and the lust of the eyes and the boastful pride of life is not from the Father, but is from the world. If you're watching this video now and you're not a Christian, if you don't want to be like the world and its evil desires, you need to listen to what Jesus said in Mark 1:15, repent and believe in the gospel. Are you watching this video now? Are you following Jesus? Well, if so, we have a beautiful scripture for you here. In Colossians 3:1-2 it reads, therefore, if you have been raised up with Christ, keep seeking the things above where Christ is, seated at the right hand of God. Set your mind on the things above, not on the things that are on the earth. And Philippians 3:20 reads, but our citizenship is in heaven. Two wonderful scriptures. A wise man once told me, keep looking up. And why? Because if you're a Christian, your citizenship is in heaven. You are no better than the world, just different. And why this subject? Well, the preacher at my local church the last 2 weeks has been speaking about this. How Christians are different and not better. So I'm just taking this, not copying him too much, don't worry about it. But if you are a Christian now, keep asking the Holy Spirit to help you, as without him, we are just like the world. And with all my points that I've just read, we need the Holy Spirit's power to help us overcome the world. But Christians, final message, let your light stand out to the world and hope that Jesus pulls your loved ones out of the world also, just like he did with you. Thanks for watching, everyone. I hope you enjoyed this video and you got something from it. If you got any questions or want to message me, then either leave a comment below or personally message me. I'll be happy to speak to you. So take care and join us next week for another episode.